Trump's Air Force One just made urgent detour on way to Asia today. Here's where he's heading now. President Donald Trump just departed on what's planned to be his longest overseas trip as Commander-in-Chief, as he was set to tour 5 countries over the next 11 days in Asia. Not long after Air Force One took off, the crew made an urgent detour en route to the Orient. Where the president is suddenly heading now is sure to make liberals' heads explode who were already critical of his trip, accusing him of leaving his troubles behind, when in fact he's facing them head-on. Trump's Asia trip has been planned for months and is an important part of his presidency. He's going there to take care of matters crucial to America, including addressing the persistent issue festering in North Korea, in which he's set to show up at Kim Jong-un's doorstep and force him to stand down in his nuclear efforts of creating a crisis. He's not forgetting the issues in the homeland that the left is claiming he's running from, as there are always problems they create and bigger issues that need his attention. It's for this reason that they aren't going to be too happy when they find out where the leader of the greatest nation in the world is headed and what he plans to do, regardless of what liberals have to say about it. The original trip was planned to be just 10 days, but Trump decided to tack on an extra day to swing by the Philippines. Liberals are essentially laughing at this, claiming that he's incapable of coming back to the U.S. with any success accomplished in this region. However, that couldn't be further from the truth, as he proved when he returned from the Middle East, having accomplished more in a few days there than Barack Obama did in 2 terms. However, he could also be heading for a surprise meetup with Russia's Vladimir Putin, which will surely send liberals' ongoing collusion controversy into overdrive. If this happens as it's rumored to, the timing is definitely Trump's awesome style, as it would be a well-played move considering all the time Congress is currently wasting on this Russian rabbit hole. Also, before he even makes it overseas, he's stopping in Hawaii for a briefing on U.S. military forces in the Pacific and a visit to Pearl Harbor. Beset by challenges at home, President Donald Trump on Friday embarks on the longest trip to Asia by an American president in more than a quarter century, looking for help to pressure to stand down from a nuclear crisis. Trump's tour of Japan, South Korea, China, Vietnam and the Philippines from Friday to November 14 will take him out of Washington, as he's preoccupied with several issues. These include an intensifying federal investigation into Russian meddling in last year's election, New York's recovery from an attack that killed 8 people, and debate over a tax cut plan that, if approved by Congress, would be his first major legislative victory. Of the meeting with Putin, the Daily Mail explains. Trump may meet Putin at the APEC summit, the Kremlin said on Friday, saying talks were underway about setting up such an encounter. Putin and Trump first met at a G20 summit in Hamburg in July when they discussed allegations of Russian meddling in the U.S. presidential election, but agreed to focus on better ties rather than litigating the past. Relations between Moscow and Washington have soured further since, however. Trump in August grudgingly signed off on new sanctions against Russia, a move Moscow said ended hopes for better ties. Putin, dismayed by the sanctions, ordered Washington to more than halve its embassy and consular staff in Russia. But when asked if Putin and Trump might meet at the summit taking place next week in Vietnam, Kremlin spokesman Dmitry Peskov said Moscow did not rule out such a meeting. The meeting, is indeed being discussed, Peskov told reporters on a conference call. It's hard to overestimate the importance and significance for all international matters of any contact between the presidents of Russia and the United States, said Peskov. Trump is also set to make history with this trip, as no other president has spent as much time in Asia on one tour as he plans to, in the last 25 years. The last time a U.S. president was in Asia for so long was in late 1991 and early 1992. When President George H.W. Bush became ill at a Japanese state dinner, Mail Online pointed out. Trump's extended absence has alarmed some allies who, after seeing a healthcare reform bid fizzle, worry the tax effort could suffer without him at close hand to keep momentum going. It is too long a trip and will only further hurt his most important priority, which is getting his legislative agenda through Congress, an outside advisor to Trump, speaking on condition of anonymity, said. Going to Asia doesn't do anything to advance his tax cuts agenda or to help him in his re-election efforts. However, White House officials pointed out just how capable and efficient our president is, by stating that he's fully able to keep his focus on a number of pressing matters no matter where he is in the world. This is in part why Americans elected him, and he hasn't disappointed since he took office. In fact, he's performed exceptionally well under more pressure than any other president has ever had to endure, with the problems on his plate and the accusations from anti-American citizens who have stopped at nothing to try to take him down, and failed.